do wonder if putting that out there through the media, if that actually does him a disservice in the attempt to try to get to the Ravens, because you almost, you advertise that that's where you want to be, and then teams are thinking, okay, well, let's look at this guy.
Yeah, Terrell, dude, this isn't the free agency period. This is the, they're 12-2 and kicking everybody's ass, and we're not going to let you just walk in there, right?
Sure, sure. But he also wouldn't be the first player that's done something like this. And look, hey, he's a 37-year-old
look
veteran.
Look at what Antonio Brown did 4 months ago, right?
Right, right. So I don't fault him, but I do wonder if it's the best strategy, if that's ultimately what you want.
Well, I mean, his strategy wasn't to go play for the miserable Arizona Cardinals this weekend, right? Like, he didn't, against the Browns, he wasn't interested in doing that for 12 snaps or whatever they were going to tap him on the shoulder for. So he made that decision. He's got $100 million in the bank. You know, let's talk hypothetical. I know John Harbaugh would not allow this, in the conversation. But, all right, so he clears everything. Luke DaCosta, you tell me. Luke Newsom, Luke Harbaugh, Luke Martindale. I've seen enough of Terrell Suggs' antics over the course of time, and I know Matt Judon might love him to come back, and Earl Thomas might like to meet him again, from their Pro Bowls time together or whatever. But I don't know, man. I'm sort of like, we're 12-2. I would sort of leave it alone for me. I mean, I said he's not Ray Lewis. He's not Ed Reed. He's Terrell Suggs. And I would leave it alone myself. Now, that being said, I don't know what the sentiment in the building is. All that being said, we know his age. We know his heart. We know how some of the players would feel about this. I don't know how some of the players that don't know him would feel about it. And I don't know what it would do to any chemistry in said game against said Texans or Bills 3 weeks from now, because we're literally talking about three football games. Like, we're not really talking about the Browns this weekend or the Steelers next week in a game that doesn't mean anything. We're talking about, do you feel like you need him the second week of January? And is that influence over the next 3 or 4 weeks, inviting that big personality, all of that back into this? Maybe we find a more humble version of Sizzle at 30. I don't know. But I on the face of it, on the personality of it, based on where the team is right now, I wouldn't mess with the team right now. And I know Dennis Colazzo's tweeted that out.
Yeah, I mean, first of all, I mean, Terrell Suggs was a much more toned-down Terrell Suggs the last few years. Let's put that out there first.
Okay, fair enough. I'll agree with that.
He just was. I mean, he was. I think I'd be inclined to do it. Just strictly from the standpoint, I mean, look, if the question is, do the Ravens need Terrell Suggs? No. I don't think the Ravens need anything right now. I think as they're currently constructed. But that
you've never said that in your life, the guy who wrote for 5 off seasons about the secondary.
but that said, that's not to say that you shouldn't still look for opportunities to get better. And if you are looking for areas of potential concern on the defense, I've talked about this a lot. This is not a great run defense. It just isn't. You can look at rushing yards per game and say, well, Luke, they're ranked in the top 5 or 10 or whatever it is. Yards per carry? No, they're not ranked in the top 5. And we have seen them have some issues on the edge. Is Terrell Suggs still a good run defender? Well, according to his PFF numbers with Arizona, he still is. Can Terrell Suggs in a situational role offer you a little bit of juice as a pass rusher? Potentially, especially when you consider he has had a lighter snap count over his final games with Arizona. He is going to have a first-round bye if you bring him into Baltimore, because the Ravens are going to have a first-round bye. They're not losing that. So with some rest, with an expectation that Wink Martindale sits down with him and says, Terrell, you're not going to be a 50-snap game kind of guy. We think you can thrive going about 20 or 25, and we'll kind of gauge it that way. If Terrell Suggs is receptive to that, and I'm sure through back channels that there's been some communication, assuming the Ravens are at least remotely interested in a reunion.
But that means less snaps for what, Ferguson, less snaps for Bowser, right? Like less snaps all the way around for several people, right?
I mean, we're not talking about guys that are playing at Pro Bowl levels. This isn't develop guys for the future. This is giving yourself the best chance to win a Super Bowl. And I, like I said, I don't think the Ravens need Terrell Suggs. I don't think Terrell Suggs takes their, let's say right now, hypothetically speaking, I've seen playoff odds, I've seen Super Bowl odds. One I saw put the Ravens at having a 35% chance of winning the Super Bowl. And that's just an arbitrary number I'm throwing out there right now. But does Terrell Suggs put them at 50%? No, of course not. Do I think he could put them from 35 to, I don't know, 35.5%? Sure, why not? You know, I'm not going to argue with that math. So if you can get a 0.5% better, if you can get 1% better, if you can feel that much more confident that you've shored up your run defense, if you feel that Terrell Suggs might have a big strip sack of Patrick Mahomes in the third quarter in the AFC
Championship.
Well,
you know, it would speak to how much that people in the building really do like him, to want him back and to welcome him. You know what I mean? Like, it would speak volumes about how they really, really feel about him, because he wasn't in the Hall of Ray or the Hall of Ed. He wasn't, right? Like,
as
a personality and as a leader and as a little bit of a goof, you know what I mean? Like, all, and not to mention Bleach, you know, all of that, right? But that being said, he had this afterlife the last 5 years, and this heart of a Raven that Harbaugh speaks of and Ozzie would speak of, that if he's dangling out there and you could rent him and he can still play as deemed by everyone who measures such things, then, you know, then I guess I will see him out there on Wednesday when I get there, right? Or, you know, if the rest of the league allows this nonsense, right?
Right. I mean, again, I'm still.
You think if he gets to the doorstep that they would welcome him back for sure?
I mean, I don't see why you wouldn't.
Okay.
From the standpoint of, you wanted him back in March. It's not as though he did anything in Arizona, at least it's come out, to suggest that he wasn't a good locker room guy there. You know, he's someone that...
Well, you know what you're getting, right? I mean, there's nobody in the building that doesn't, from the secretaries to the PR, nobody there knows what they're buying with Terrell Suggs when he comes in, and knows that it's only going to last 5 weeks, you know? Little sizzle goes a long way, right?
Yeah,
it's like summer
put it this
camp,
way.
You know?
Put it this way. Do I think there's tremendous upside to it? No. Do I think there's tremendous downside to it? No. Do I think Terrell Suggs, could he help them a little bit here and there? Yeah. Do I think he's going to sabotage the chemistry that they have in the locker room? Absolutely not. So from that standpoint, I'm kind of...
You've checked a lot of the reasons to do it. You really have.
I mean,
you,
why not?
You've been very sensible in your assessment of all of this. Because, you know, he was never my favorite player. I mean,
sure.
You know, on a human standpoint, just, you know, I mean, Ray and Ed checked different boxes than he did for me.
Sure, and that's fair. And to be very clear, hypothetically, let's say Terrell Suggs goes unclaimed, which means the Ravens wouldn't claim him either. I'm not going to fault the Ravens, and I say, oh, okay, they must feel pretty good about their edge guys. We'll see. I'm not quite as confident in those guys, but that's fine. I'll respect that, and if you don't want to rock the boat. But at the same time, when we're talking about chemistry and bringing someone else in new, they brought in a lot of guys. So, you know, if you're willing to bring in Marcus Peters, who, let's face it, was someone who did have a reputation for being a strong alpha male personality, if you're willing to bring him in, who you had no history with other than a couple pre-draft visits, then I don't think that, you know, Terrell Suggs being, you know, a big personality would be a deterrent. I think it's much more a case of, do you think he can play? Do you think he can help you? And, you know, if the answer is yes, then I think you bring him in, because I don't think there's a lot of downside there. I don't think there's a ton of upside.
Well, you know one thing. He wants to be here, right? Like, you
sure.
know what I mean? So you know, that much you know. So you're getting a very motivated version of Terrell Suggs, which, you know, over the course of 15 years, that's why he's a Hall of Fame player, right? Because
yeah.
The motivated version of him is usually the good version.
Yeah. So I really don't view this as something that is...
See, you've turned me around in 26 minutes, see? You know, it's amazing.
I just don't think it's really that big of a deal breaker. I mean, and here's the other thing. If he comes in and for whatever reason there would be a problem, then get rid of him. I mean, you let him walk once, you know, so, you know, Randy Moss went back to Minnesota and they let him go again.
Antonio Brown didn't last 36 hours in New England or whatever it was.
And let's be clear about this. Say what you want about Terrell Suggs' personality, whether, you know, how you feel about him personally, how anyone feels about him personally. By all accounts, this guy, especially late in his career, was considered a good teammate.
Oh, 1 o'clock Sunday, you want him on your team.
Yeah.
There's no doubt about that.
From that standpoint, to me, I say sure. Do I think he's going to end up being a Raven? No, because I think someone else is going to claim him. And this is all going to be a moot point, but I don't think there is a ton of downside. I don't think there's a whole lot of upside, but again, if you can make yourself a half of a 1% better, then isn't it worth it? I mean, the whole idea is to win the Super Bowl, right? And if Terrell Suggs comes back and can help them be a little bit better against the run and maybe have a big strip sack at some point in the postseason, then it was worth it for a couple $100,000 and a waiver claim. So we'll see how it plays out. Again, I'm still guessing that it's not going to be a decision the Ravens ultimately are going to even be able to make, because I think there are going to be at least a couple other playoff contenders to say, we'll get Terrell Suggs to come play for us and not make the 12-2 Ravens even better than they already are.
And in our next segment, we will discuss rollerblading with Tom Brady and Lamar Jackson on grass. He is Luke Jones, Baltimore Luke at on Twitter. He will be through the holidays on the backfields at Knowings Mills, as will I in Cleveland this week. Back, email me. I'm putting Super Bowl plans together. Pinch me. It's crazy. If you want to go to South Florida with us, if the Ravens were to get there, I'm putting the plans together. Throw me an email, nasty@WNST.net. We're out in the bay at Toyota.com Audio Vault 24 hours a day from anywhere in the world. We got a lot of new sponsors. I got my Liberty Pure Solutions hat on. I'm drinking clean, fresh water. We're going to be talking about that this week. I got my Full Circle shirt on up here in the studio, my Royal Farms coffee cup, my Strategic Factory energy drink. Thank you. Getting me some energy. I got a Cole roofing mug. Got a Pizza John's cup, but there's no pizza in it, or a cheesesteak, so I'm going to have to fix that over on Back River Neck Road. And Sporticulture, Court's going to be checking in. Last-minute gifts, last-minute flowers, last-minute lava lamps. Find all that at sporticulture.com. Big thanks to our friends at Planet Fitness as well for sponsoring our morning newspaper. Comes digitally to your inbox each and every morning at 7 a.m. Planet Fitness. You can come to Planet Fitness beginning 2020 the right way. $5 down, $10 a month. Get yourself in the best shape of your life. Got to work off all that eggnog I've been drinking. It's the eggnog and pumpkin season. It's getting to me. Last but never least, any breaking news, Terrell Suggs or otherwise, you get it first on the WNSD Tech Service. That's all brought to you by Coons Ford of Security Boulevard. Dennis Colazzos will be here on Thursday from 3 until 5. It is the Dennis Colazzos Show. Pete, Luke, myself, everybody chipping in, talking some football, getting you ready for Cleveland this weekend. And, of course, if there's breaking news, it always happens first on the Tech Service brought to you by Coons Ford of Security Boulevard. I am Nestor. We are WNST.net, AM 1570, and WNST Towson, Baltimore. And we never stop talking Baltimore positive and Baltimore sports.